Hello everyone, myself Professor Jinal Nayak, working as an assistant professor at SNPIT and RC Umrakh Bardoli. Here I am going to discuss the topic harmonic mean from the subject probability and statistics. Basically, harmonic mean is a measure of central tendency. When data consists of rates of change such as speed, the harmonic mean is an appropriate measure of central tendency. Harmonic mean is not used if any observation is given zero. Now we see the classification of data. Generally, data can be classified as ungrouped data and grouped data. Ungrouped data is also known as raw data. Grouped data is given in interval form. The ungrouped data can also be classified again as data without frequencies and data with frequencies. Now we see how to find harmonic mean for all this type of data. So first we see the harmonic mean for ungrouped data. When ungrouped data is given without frequencies, the harmonic mean can be calculated as given here. The harmonic mean for set of n observations xi is defined as the reciprocal of. This says that harmonic mean is reciprocal of. Reciprocal, that means 1 upon something. Now, reciprocal of which arithmetic mean? Now, arithmetic mean, that means summation of given objects upon total number of objects. So 1 upon that arithmetic mean. Now we see arithmetic mean of which term? Arithmetic mean of reciprocal of individual observations. So again, arithmetic mean of reciprocal, that means 1 upon something. 1 upon what? That is individual observation. And observation is here given xi. That means here 1 upon xi arithmetic mean, that is divided by total number of observation, here we have that is n. So this. So ultimately harmonic mean is this. Reciprocal of this arithmetic mean of reciprocal of each observation, and we can write this as simplified form n upon summation 1 upon xi. Now we see the harmonic mean of ungrouped data when it is given with frequencies. In case of frequency distribution for ungrouped data, for n observations x1, x2 up to xn with frequencies f1, f2 up to fn respectively, the harmonic mean is given by. Now here also the concept is same. Harmonic mean, that means reciprocal of something. Again, reciprocal of arithmetic mean of something. Now, arithmetic mean, that means summation of that objects upon total number of objects. Clearly, it is given total n observations, but further we are given frequencies. So, when we find arithmetic mean of data with frequencies, we have to always divide whatever the sum of objects by total frequencies. And here we have to make sum of again reciprocal of observations. Our observations are xi. So reciprocal is 1 upon xi. As it is frequency distribution, we will multiply each of this reciprocal by its respective frequency. So ultimately this is the formula to find harmonic mean when the ungrouped data with frequencies are given. This is same as this fi into 1 upon xi. We have written it fi upon xi. And we define this summation I 1 to n fi as capital N. That is total number of frequencies. Now we see the harmonic mean for grouped data. Whenever we are given group data, that means all the observations are given interval wise. Suppose we are given such interval A to B, then obviously it is the lower limit and this is the upper limit for it. And keep in mind that whenever we are given group data and we have to make such term, we have to use midterm of each the interval. So for group data with frequency, the harmonic mean is defined as this. Here capital N is total number of frequencies, fi that is frequency, and mi that is mid value of interval. Here also we can have the same concept that harmonic mean is reciprocal of something. Reciprocal of arithmetic mean. Arithmetic mean is summation of objects upon total objects. But here it is given with frequency, so we have to divide this by total frequency fi. Now we have to find arithmetic mean of reciprocal. But here we are given group data, that means we are given data value interval wise. We have to find mi, mid value for each interval, and we will find reciprocal of that mid value, and then we multiply each of them with respective frequency, and ultimately we will have this formula. So concept is very clear and very easy. Just we have to make sure that when we have to use mid values and when we have to use directly observations. Thank you very much. I hope you are clear about the harmonic mean.